If you wanted to get from here in London to here in New York in under 2 hours, you'd need to be moving fast, really fast. Hypersonic, to be precise.
And that's exactly the aim of aviation startups Destinus and Hermeus.
Companies like these are aiming to build passenger planes that will travel at Mach 5, more than twice the speed of Concorde, dramatically reducing the amount of time it would take to fly anywhere.
Now, while these companies have made progress developing new engines, conducting tests, and signing contracts with partners,
right now, their hypersonic dreams are not quite there yet.
So as always, we're going to look at where these companies are now, where they want to be in the future, and what they need to do to get there.
But before we get into that, I want to explain to you how these companies plan on flying hypersonically.
Their aim is to create a new engine by combining turbojets with ramjet technology.
Now, if that sounds familiar, you might have seen it in Top Gun Maverick.
Transitioning to scramjet.
Albeit with a faster scramjet engine. But if you don't know what any of that means, I asked Hermeus' CEO to explain it to me like I was a five-year-old.
You compress air, you burn it, and then you exhaust it through a nozzle to generate thrust. On the turbojet side, you need a mechanical compressor to compress the air, and you need a turbine to power the compressor. So with a ramjet, you compress it with a shockwave. So it's naturally done just based on the speed that you're going.
That's why these companies plan on using a combination of both engines, a turbojet to take off and get you fast enough for a ramjet to kick in and take you hypersonic. And ramjet technology isn't new. It's actually been proven to work years ago.
What we demonstrated today is something that we've been working on in the ground for over 40 years.
So now Destinus and Hermeus are hoping to use that tech to carry passengers.
In 10, 15 years, you can have the first passenger plane, not big one, not like a Boeing 777, kind of small one, like business jet.
That's Mikhail Kokorich, CEO of Destinus, who hopes to have its 25-seat Destinus S aircraft ready for commercial service by 2030. And Hermeus aims to have its 20-seat Halcyon aircraft carrying paying passengers by around the same time.
We're not so naive to think that we could do that right off the bat. So we've laid out a roadmap of three aircraft that will incrementally buy down the technical risk as well as the business risk.
As for the ticket costs, well, that would be down to the airline. But Hermeus told me that, much like Concorde, it could be charged at a premium price.
But all of that is in the future. And right now, both of these companies are a long way from carrying passengers. Both have been working on that tricky turbojet-ramjet problem by taking existing engines and modifying them. Destinus has also managed to fly some test flights, albeit with smaller scale models with smaller engines.
After 2.5 years, we tested two prototypes. We are building the supersonic prototype, which will be the first supersonic unmanned vehicle in Europe.
And both companies are using the knowledge that they're gaining from pursuing hypersonic flight to sell products and services.
Hermeus plans to use its development aircraft as a testbed for the US military, signing a $60 million deal with the US Air Force.
So for the flight test services that conducts, we'll provide those as a service to our customers, be they the US government, ally partners, or industry.
But in order for these companies to progress from engine testing to commercial hypersonic flight, they're going to have to find the solutions to a lot of unanswered questions.
For starters, there are physics questions, like how to handle the extreme temperatures as the aircraft hits its top speed.
There's also questions around how passengers will feel while accelerating to Mach 5. Because while these aircraft won't go off like a rocket, there still will be a sustained period where you're accelerating.
So the climb and acceleration period on a hypersonic aircraft will last, I'd say, 12 to 15 minutes, depending on the trajectory.
Then there's operational questions, like how to avoid creating a sonic boom over land, and how that affects your routes and scheduling. Destinus told me they'd still be quicker than most flights, even if they had to travel extra mileage to avoid land.
For hypersonic, when you fly in 5-6 Mach, it's like 2 hours and a half or 3 hours. It's still extremely fast compared with a direct flight of 12 hours.
There's even questions around how regular these flights would need to become economically successful. After all, it's great saying that you can fly from London to New York in 90 minutes, but that's not much use if the flight doesn't depart for another 6 hours. And let's not forget, we're now more connected in the air than we've ever been before. And that means that the number of people willing to pay a premium to travel at ultra-fast speeds could be lower than it used to be. All of that means that the economics around hypersonic flight is still wildly uncertain.
So for hypersonic flight to take off, these companies are going to have to develop their engines, flight test and certify their aircraft, receive regulatory approval for their sonic boom creating flights, establish routes, prove that the experience can be safe and comfortable, and then prove there's a market for hypersonic flight.
That's a long road to be able to carry paying passengers. So while these companies say that this technology might be right around the corner, if you want to travel somewhere hypersonically fast, you might have to wait a while first.